I obviously wasn't given the spinning top as a child like I should have been. You wouldn't even remember them, you remember, but you're a little bit. I'll bring one in to show you what it is, John. I struggled with phones. There wasn't even phones when I was young. Yeah, Stevie's gone to take off his tracksuit and gather themselves. Arthur's game is a very game, really. He actually can use power, but he's got very good touch as well.
Yeah, he's like, well, it's mostly any player really under professional circuit these days needs a bit of ball game. They need to be able to vary their game quite a bit. It's mostly that of power will only get you so far. Starting with in this game, just
to get it started.
Yeah, just to get a little ball in the game, and see how much pressure can really put after on
them. I meant to say, I got a text from a friend of mine who said that the game this morning was brilliant and the commentary was too. They were only referring to you.
Okay.
I was saying earlier. A few years ago, I was just sitting at the door, just minding the door, you know, to stop people coming in. And the same friend sent me a text saying, "And see, they finally found a job you could do."
Irish Clash National Champions 2016. Men's semi final match. Yeah. A.Gaskin to serve, Steve Richardson to concede. That's 5 games. The ball.
Joe Ruddy. Michael McBride.
And out, 1-0.
Thank you. Nick.
A bit fortunate for Arthur at the end.
And that's the
score so far.
That'll help to settle Arthur anyway.
I do think Arthur will be quite happy with the longer rallies.
Yeah, of course he will.
Richardson.
No, thank you. professional refereeing decision, yet he may have a point.
And
I think he has a point. Over that. Neighbouring it.
5-7.
Thank you. We'll have to take some one game to love lead. Superb long rallies, aren't they?
There's some very good squash being played and some great retrieving. I think Connor happy to come up with
first one.
Yeah, nine, yeah.
He will. Because in a way, Stevie's best chance was to win early and to take a lead. And
yeah, it's a big
it is huge from that, especially because it's going to be so attritional, really. Arthur's movement is just exquisite. He's back to the tee so quickly, and his covering is just effortless. So frustrating when you're playing someone who keeps getting to every shot.
Yeah, well, he picked up like Steve threw some very, very good drops in there at times, and threw some good balls in there, and Arthur seemed to just pick him up at ease.
Yeah, he picked him up with time to pick his counter shot as well. Lovely squash. What got you interested in squash in the first place?
I suppose the it was my father actually started joining the local squash club in Clare many years ago, and we just tagged along with him, and I'm stuck with the squash racket ever since.
Poor thing.
Yeah, it was actually the
15 seconds.
The club in Blarney would have been the Blarney Williams Christie Squash Club, which would have hosted a couple of Irish Opens back in the there was an Irish Open in 1987-88, which would have had players like Jan Sherkin and a few other top players in the world would have played there. So it was actually quite a busy squash club, quite a good squash club at the time, but unfortunately, like so many other clubs, they kind of
just not economical.
Just kind of dug away.
Who coached you in the early years?
In the early years, we would have had a club professional. Evan Hooley would have been a club professional in Derry. Actually, the very first professional player we had in the Derry would have been a guy called Zarek.
That's
one game to be a top 10 in the world player.
The ball.
Back to the real world. That's a beautiful
one
as well.
Four love.
there so early, he's got so much time to position his body and control.
He's taken a lot of credit here at the moment, and he's really giving stuff, giving him very little to work on.
Thank you.
was unfortunate. Super rally.
Super rally out to Steve. Steve had actually been most of the walking out rally, but he just... Yeah.
9-2.
Yeah. He was picking them up with ease. It wasn't as if he was picking them up on full stretch. Gone for a 90-second break. I don't know where Stevie can go from here, really, because he's just been pushed beyond his, playing beyond himself.
Yeah, no wonder, really, all the time. To be very fair, Steve actually
did a very good squash. He did, yeah. He's doing some absolutely brilliant stuff, but it wasn't dented. Just wasn't... overstretching Arthur at all.
We'll have to wait and see. He's not meant to
he doesn't give up easy, though.
No, so yeah. He'll definitely come on, give it a go here, which is...
You just have a sense he's playing slightly harder than his body wants to. And Arthur's just keeping him at that tempo. And I mean, I'm sure you find too, when you're playing someone that's a little bit ahead of you, you're pushing yourself so much that it really digs at your body very quickly.
Definitely.
You go into distress very quick.
Arthur looks so comfortable.
Yeah, he looks well in control.
15 seconds. So,
which I have to say, I think... that's a far better Arthur squash player than I saw last year and the year before.
Yeah, he looks
seriously impressed.
Yeah,
he's superb.
I was actually talking to him this morning, and he said that he has a loop, or he's getting coaching at the moment from an ex-professional.
Right.
And he's really enjoying the squash now at the moment. Yeah. And
it's nice.
It's certainly showing up, because actually, coming into this, I was sort of thinking that either Sean or Brian would push Arthur quite hard, particularly Brian. If Brian gets through, it's hard to know with Sean. But a mammoth task ahead of them with Arthur.
Definitely, yeah, because Arthur looks to be quite sharp.
Yeah,
Steve's playing really good squash at the moment.
It's not denting him at all.
No, it's not.
That's the needs to get stuff.
Third game, Joe Ruddy calls it. It's a nice stop.
What's up?
Mostly because he has to be so precise with him. Trying too much.
Yeah.
What
today? I was noticing really hungry this morning and last night. He wasn't actually playing them as winners. He was just playing them as
winners. He was really to
one, two.
And to make his opponent work. Willingness to play six and eight balls, kind of the same, just to force it and keep pushing. lovely job of staying here.
Four.
Probably 80% of us when we look for a stroke there.
He just played it away. Well, maybe possibly would have been a hard stroke, so yeah. I think he probably knew that. He just got off the rally.
Stevie.
And there's 5-4.
Yeah. was going to say, he's enjoying himself running around. That is superb,
and out, 6-10, match ball.
Great, the squad, well played, lads. Superb.